Your DVR on the go from anywhere. And now introducing TV Start Over. Restart a show that's already in progress. Now you won't miss a minute of your show when you're running late. How about some of the nation's fastest internet speeds, not only at home, but when you're on the go with mobile Wi-Fi hotspots? How about having the most intelligent home on the block with lighting and temperature control, 24/7 security, and firewall from any PC or tablet? All services are backed with a 30-day guarantee, and prices starting at just $49.99, you can't lose. Don't delay. Local reps are waiting for your call. Just dial 866-616-9724. Again, that number is 866-616-9724.
CBC 5 is the executive liaison for all your building compliance needs. Serving South Florida from the Palm Beaches to Key West, CBC 5 delivers five-star service that brings...
What's this ABC or BDQ or whatever?
CBC 5. It stands for Complete Building Compliance.
Oh, well, I ain't building nothing, so what can they do for me?
Well, they do more than plan, review, and permitting. They help the little guy cut through red tape.
I got duct tape holding together my carport.
Well, CBC 5 can help. Let them deal with bureaucrats. They helped George Rodriguez solve a sewer lateral problem, and they saved him a ton of money and hassles.
Fight City Hall, who can do that?
CBC 5 can do that. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have a commercial to finish. Contact Shoddy the Hottie at CBC 5 786-255-3851 or log on to cbc5.net. That's cbc5.net.
By the Glass.
By the Glass is a show about beverage culture.
Brad Hubbard.
What I'm going to do is I'm going to connect the dots on how everything works together. It's really all about how we enjoy things, how we enjoy life, and how beverages play a big part in that. I'm going to bring in people that are going to display their aspect of the culture. I'm going to bring in people that are going to show you different products. We're going to look at places where people go to consume these beverages and how they all interact. Things are built around the actual beverage itself.
By the Glass. Thursdays from 6 to 7. Only on SoFlo Radio.
The importance of a yeah, we're back to work.
I took one of the greatest bands in the history of hip hop. EPMD.
There's no such thing as a band in hip hop. Except for the Roots. Except for the Roots.
Well, the Roots are a band, right?
The Roots are a band because they use instruments. Every other person is considered.
NERD too.
NERD
too.
NERD
too. Yeah, but that's not really hip hop.
They're like alternative
bass. What'd you say?
NERD?
Never heard of them.
Oh, NERD.
For real.
Yeah,
those guys are whack.
Wow.
Chill, this is, don't even, man.
You say that the nerd is whack. Don't you say?
Yeah.
No, bad form. I don't appreciate that. anything for real on is the real deal, man.
For real.
Where's he from, first of all?
Virginia.
Oh, he's whack. Hot damn.
Wow. So what? You comments from Chicago? You think he's whack too? Yeah. So your opinion
everyone from Virginia just coin. This is whack. Is that what you're saying?
If you're not from New York,
so you say Missy's whack too? Is that what you're saying?
That's what he's saying.
Missy. Whack,
Mrs. Elliott.
Yeah,
that's absolutely whack, dude.
Really?
That's awful, awful, awful. Yeah, let's close that door. Around.
What about the clips?
Awful.
You don't even, man. Your opinion is I'm an old
grumpy man.
No, but you're not even consistent, though.
What do you
mean?
Hey,
I'm sorry. Speaking of of the clips, dude. Yeah, he got his first track out after he just had this little thing with Kim Kardashian, his little baby, whatever.
Yeah.
He got a beat for Pusha T called Put Numbers on the Board. I usually hype a lot of artists now. Badass. Y'all got to check this, man.
Pusha T, the truth.
Pusha T. Said, I put numbers on the board. The other half of the clips.
He just need to cut them whack-ass braids, man.
Yeah.
No, he doesn't.
It's 2013. Let's get right.
Please. UD just cut his off, like, last season.
Yeah.
Real life.
I think Pusha T need to jump on that bandwagon.
Man, it's like Samson, man. You see what happened to Busta Bust without his braids, man.
Yeah.
It's like Samson. You know
he
what I'm
lost
saying?
All his... Yeah, all his flow, man.
And got all his steroids.
All right, since you guys are not interested in baseball, he's gonna
allegedly.
I'm going to go and through a couple things.
Let's go Sox.
Sox.
You went to the game.
Not.
I went to the Marlins.
Yeah. They won the series.
I went to the game. It was slugfest. It was like 9-7 after the second.
Yeah. What?
And they ended up getting absolutely routed that game. The next game, we were going to go back, and we didn't because it was so hot, and I almost got sick from how hot it was. And then that was a game they beasted the Cardinals.
Yeah.
Me and my boy went to the game. We gave it to Matt Holliday.
Was Stan playing?
Stan did play. He had a home run that game. He had a nice wall catch.
I think that's the one where he hit his 100th home run or something like that, the quickest to hit 100 home runs?
Stanton's probably hits the ball harder than anybody.
Yeah,
in the
he does.
That's about all he could do.
Then he got mad at us, man, because I refused to call him Giancarlo. He's Michael to me, and I called him as such. And I told him that, and I don't think
Some guy at work was telling me that Cabrera hits the ball harder. I go, what are you, crazy, Stanton? I'm not saying Cabrera's a better player than Stanton, obviously. Yeah.
But Stanton, the ball flies off his bat.
Oh.
Dude, he broke the scoreboard.
Yeah, the only guy I could compare Stanton to is Barry Bonds. When I used to
Gary
watch
Sheffield.
I don't do that.
Barry Bonds used to hit some shots, man. Line shots.
In his defense, right now.
Gary Sheffield was another one, too.
We were talking about it just earlier, though. You know who just absolutely tattoos the ball right now is that kid from the Orioles, Chris Davis.
He
puts some stink on that ball. How he hits that ball at the park.
But it's bombs, but it's not Stanton. That thing looks like it'll hurt you.
He hit one in Arizona a couple nights ago. Woo.
I wouldn't want to catch that. If I'm a fan, I'm just going, well, I just hope it lands somewhere near me and I'll get it off the floor. Because you try to catch that thing barehand, your hand's going to come off.
I'm just gonna say a couple things about the Marlins. I know you guys don't want to hear about the Marlins because on Tuesday's show I spent 4 segments on the Marlins.
How about the Renaissance of Juan Pierre? He's been playing badass recently, man. He's been playing real well.
But the thing I want to
did he go see Dr. Bosch?
Too soon, man.
I want to point out a couple things. Evoldi's back from the disabled list. Lomo's back from the disabled list, and obviously we talked about Stanton already back. And they got Ozuna, who's an all star.
Dude, he sucks so bad. I saw him at the game. He's terrible.
He's terrible. He started out good.
Yeah. He got sent down for good reason, dude. The game I saw
him down.
Dude, I'm telling you, the game I saw of him, he played so bad. Not even playing, making mistakes. He wasn't hustling.
Yeah.
We caught him. He came, you know, like sometimes they get caught in between. The ball falls in between the shortstop and the second center fielder. He's calling him. Like, dude, come. It's over.
He's a rookie, man, yeah.
He's just standing there. And then he didn't run out. He didn't hustle out to second base. And then in that game we saw, he came out the game and they brought somebody else in.
Yeah.
I'm telling you, it was embarrassing how un-hustling
he was. I watched the game where he dropped 2 easy fly balls.
Yeah. He's a rookie. But he's got potential, man. He's
Whatever.
He's going to be.
If you don't hustle, there's no place for you in sports, bro.
Ozuna's
not
a beast,
any
man.
Place for you in sports. You don't hustle, there's no excuse. There's no place for you in sports.
LeBron.
Don't worry about it. He's not saying anything out of this world.
What happened to Wade? I thought Wade was the captain of the team. He was
Wade says it. He says it before the game, like before they even come out, and then Wade's
in the tunnel. It's LeBron on the court.
Right.
All right, the Yankees, Euclid, and Teixeira back in the
look,
same.
Look at my face.
Came back.
Man, the Yankees, they hurt. Oh my God.
Euclid with a bad back, and Teixeira hurt his wrist again. So back in the DL.
See, I like that. See,
you guys catch a doubleheader.
That's how socks.
I know you guys are hating.
Womp.
Yankees and Dodgers series.
I saw the Dodgers putting the beats on him.
I remember in 1977. I remember that series.
You talking about Kurt?
When Jackson went deep 3 times, Mr. October. I still remember that. I was born in 1970, so I was, 7 years old? And I still remember that. Machado, we talked about Machado. Machado's a beast. Chris Davis is leading the American League in home runs.
It's going to be us and the Orioles. You know that, right? It's going down. The AL is going down. I'm absolutely taking the Yankees out of that equation right now.
Look, Dio's leaving because we're talking baseball.
No.
What a jerk off you are. Jeez.
That's not fair, man.
Come just saying.
We all suffer, man.
Hey, and the Mets have 2 great pitchers, Matt Harvey and this new kid they brought up, Wheeler.
The Mets are. How are
they
even relevant?
They suck, but they got a good pitching lineup. This kid Wheeler is. You hear about Wheeler deal?
Yes.
Okay.
Zach Wheeler.
Yeah, he's good.
Young guy, and Matt Harvey is absolutely spectacular.
He had a no hitter going to the 7th.
Yeah, no. They have a really bad team with 2 prize possessions in David Wright and
Isn't
Matt Harvey.
Isn't that the story
outside
of New York team?
Awful. Oh no, I mean, yeah.
I love the hate.
It's facts.
It's factual.
If you ask me what I'm talking about,
why can't it be factual? Just because you have to be in it, it's got to be hatred. Why can't you be factual?
If you ask me what I'm talking about,
I
could easily use that argument against the New York Knicks. I could easily use that argument towards them.
I love it.
He's that for the Yankees, bro.
And the reason why I'm wearing his hat is because of this guy Puig. I gotta get a jersey. This guy's unbelievable.
I didn't question. As long as it's not a New York hat, I don't care what you can.
Yaceli.
I didn't even
Yaciel.
Yaciel Puig.
Yes. Yeah.
How do you say it in English?
You know how? Yaciel.
Yaciel Puig.
I don't know, man.
Hey,
he's Cuban. He's got a made up ass name.
You saw that? He was doing the Yankees dirty.
Yeah.
He had a diving catch, a home run. He's out running, stealing the bases.
He's an athletic monster.
We might have to get to the Frostbites next segment. Is that okay with you, Jack?
No, that's no problem at all.
Because we're here ranting on some baseball stuff, but.
No, you got to suck it into it.
How much time we got, Dio, before we go to break?
No, you got time. You got about 6 minutes.
Oh, that's not enough for Frost. Frosty probably needs like a half a segment, right, Frost? maybe the whole segment.
No, I'm good. It's on you.
No, we'll do the next segment. We'll give you, so you don't have to rush. And
damn, I like this. They can't see. It's like printed out, color coordinated folders over here. This is pretty sweet. What you got going on, bro?
Yeah, he's ready, man. He's ready. Frostbites. We got a little song to open up for his segment.
Just a little something for the crowd.
Let's hear a couple. Anybody catch the U.S. Open golf?
Right. I did. Ugh, missed that one, Jay. My bad.
Isn't that?
I think, keyed up for that too.
I think I had a father to spend that day with.
So did I.
I think I was passing a kidney stone.
Speaking of fathers, you had a good. That was a great day. I had a great day that day. It was awesome spending time with the family.
That's good.
Yeah.
You know why Father's Day kind of irks me? Not that I love my dad. I love being alive.
Yeah.
My mom's like my dad. Like, what is that about? You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. You feel me? Like, I love the idea of actual being good fathers because my dad so wasn't.
Yeah.
Maybe if I ever had kids, I'm going to do the opposite of what he did. But it's like, this should be like a dad's day. You know what I'm saying? Father's Day is like giving credit to people that aren't good fathers. You know what I'm saying? I personally have a high problem with that or a high... You know, I can't think of the word right now, but
I know a few people that celebrated.
Do you get what I'm saying?
Like, celebrate both Mother's Day and Father's Day with mom.
Yeah,
like mom gets both.
I call
days.
My mom's on Father's Day. Yeah, like I love you. You know what I'm saying? Like that's my dad. I call my mom first time I sexual relations. I call my mom. You know, isn't that weird? It's like, hey, I'm talking that to my mom about this. It's strange. You know what I'm saying? Talking about I shave and this and that with my mom. You know what I'm saying? So it's her birthday. It was just 2 days ago. You know what I'm saying? I had to give her props because it's like Father's Day is great, and people that are good fathers, I respect them. But it's like. My mom is my dad, my mom, my this, my dad, my coach, my therapist. You know what I'm saying? So I always get weird feelings on Father's Day.
How about soccer? Anybody into soccer?
Yeah, man. Confederation Cup going on.
Oh, man. Seriously?
Nah, see, that's sarcasm.
Oh, my God.
I think Spain just beat, who was
Spain
it?
Spain annihilated Tahiti. Nothing. Dude, if Nigeria beats Tahiti 6-1, I didn't even want to know what Spain was going to do. That was an annihilation.
Spain gave Tahiti that work.
They have like a nothing. Mercy
really
rule.
About soccer, oh, my God. You know, box the crap out of me.
Does hockey have a mercy rule?
I apologize
rule?
If we're offending any soccer fans.
Does soccer have a mercy rule?
Dude. No.
Come on. Play 90 minutes of soccer and then play like 55 minutes more. Like, wasn't 90 minutes enough? Like,
hey, man, you're not
talking about
American,
stop time, and then it keeps
football.
Going on. Like, dude.
Hey, USA
had quite enough of this.
They got a good team, man.
Well, they beat Honduras 1-0. They just closed the Altidore, the Haitian sensation.
They got a couple more points and they qualify. They're assuring for the World Cup. USA.
Oh, yeah, if Clinton Dempsey and Josie Altidore is finally
Dempsey's
playing.
Dempsey's awesome, man.
No, Dempsey.
No, I think they got a car accident, right? Altidore came back from the car accident.
Yeah.
No, yeah.
See, I know a little bit.
Bradley's nice.
Yeah, Bradley's really good. And now, I mean, I don't know if Robbie Rogers is going to play for the American team. He had retired for a brief.
They came out, right?
Yeah, he came out. He's really good, though. So hopefully he'll come back. He's a great midfielder. And, hey, you want to do some soccer talk?
Wait a minute. We came out. Pause.
He's the first active.
No, yeah. Robbie Rogers is
gay sports player.
Pause.
Yeah.
We're not going to go to Roy Hibbert, so I use another term instead of what he used.
Steph, you think...
Pause.
You think the Boston Bruins are going to beat the Blackhawks in the Stanley Cup Finals?
Game 6.
You like the Bruins?
We're clinching in the bean, though.
I don't want Tal Jones to
get me
this
going,
conversation,
bro.
But you like the Bruins?
Tucarasta.
You hate on the Hawks against the Kings.
I hate the Hawks any day.
You said the Kings are going to sweep the Hawks or something like that.
I hate the Hawks any day.
Be calm and
Because you're a Red Wings fan, obviously.
Be calm and Bergeron.
Frost, who you think who's winning the Stanley Cup, Frost?
You already know. Come on, Doug.
The team with the white people.
That would be both.
Has there ever been any Spanish people playing?
They actually were.
Hockey, yeah.
They actually was.
I want to limit say never.
Wasn't there the Puerto Rican guy, the Mighty Ducks?
No.
Yeah, Milo Estevez. That's funny. Jay, that's good stuff, bro.
No, Luongo. Roberto Luongo?
He's not Hispanic.
He's Italian, dude. Stop it.
No, he's not Spanish.
Speaking of Italians, the guy on Tony Soprano died.
Gandolfini, rest in peace. Yeah. It's a tough thing when you actually take your role seriously and start really doing cocaine and trying to bankroll,
long
was that
the
like
actual
you're really
story?
A mob boss. No, I just made that up. I'm saying the dude that was on his show caught a homicide case, like getting his door kicked in, being made up. Like, you're not really a gangster, bro. You're just an actor. You went to Harvard, fam. Stop it. You know what I'm saying? Just knock it off, man.
I caught The Sopranos after all the seasons were over. I bought the DVDs. I was curious to watch. And I saw the first episode, I fell in love with it. I was having
marathons. Incredibly badass.
I watched like 15 episodes, Dio, in one day.
Yeah, no, I'm going to do that now.
You feel me, right? It's like you don't see him as James Gandolfini. You see him as Tony Soprano. You see him in another movie like, oh, look, Tony Soprano got another gig. That's sweet.
Yeah.
It's like a lot of...
Were you into
The
Sopranos?
Were
you into The Sopranos?
No.
No?
No.
It's like a lot of uncertainty around all that stuff that happened to him because I think he was being honored in Sicily.
Yes. Well, what happened was it was like a boys' trip celebrating his
For him and his son.
His son's eighth grade graduation.
Yeah.
And yes, he was getting awarded in like in Sicily.
If anybody wanted to know, Manu starred. He's coming out smoking. He's hitting a triple. It. Just called in case anyone wanted to know.
Was that your fight, Scalafini?
I was gonna touch on it, but not really in depth. Okay, I had other things, but it
my
was
bad, my bad.
No, it's all good. I mean,
the flow of the conversation.
Yeah, that's the whole thing.
Because I saw the and look at the New York Post here, and I see the front.
You know
page.
Who killed that show, man? I loved his wife in that, bro. It's like Edie Falco.
Oh my god, and she's great as Nurse killed Jackie that. Too.
And also in Oz, she was badass in that too, bro. See Oz. She was the CEO in Oz.
Tony's
too.
Daughter was beautiful.
So Meadow, whatever her name is in real life,
she's beautiful. All right, what's the score here? 11-4, San Antonio.
Oh, relax.
Oh, look, they're already leaving. The fans are leaving already. The lower bowl is
You know what I enjoyed thoroughly? Chris Bosh calling out punk-ass fans. Yeah, what's up with leaving early, bro? Yeah. Well, you know who you are. You should be ashamed of yourself.
So
you should literally run out in traffic, man, and commit suicide. Like, you have no purpose on earth. You have no purpose on earth, bro. How dare you wear a Heat jersey? Disrespect the good fans of Miami, bro.
Come on.
I'm thoroughly embarrassed by that.
Hey, yeah. I'm digging Special K over there, man.
You feel me, right? Like, that's crazy talk, man. That's how you
gonna
get up.
Because at the end of the day, it is a representation of whether you like it or not.
Whether
that
you like
people
it or
are going to not, relate. Bro, people are going to relate that to Heat fans.
Everybody was clowning the Heat fans. The ESPN.
Nah, I saw you got into it on a boy on Facebook. I like that. You got into it. Come on, you know I got your back.
Dude, he wanted to, I think he wanted
actually
to fight.
Personal beef, like you want to scrap, but you're like, dog, don't get banged out, homie. You know what I'm saying? Enjoy your little picket fence and the wife, and just don't get banged out.
I had to like calm down and tell me, I didn't mean all the Heat fans.
I saw it. Don't renege. Don't, hey, said I got your back, right? Jay, I got your back, bro.
I didn't want him to, whatever.
Yeah,
people taking catching feelings over you know, half ass halftime Heat fans. Like, don't get mad, bro. You know what I'm saying? It's what it is.
Yeah.
The people that get really upset, like, you're just giving more. You're justifying the fact that that's who you're calling fans. If you don't retaliate, you're not giving them any light.
If I went to a Celtics game and somebody got up in the fourth quarter and walked out, I guarantee they're getting drenched with beer. My people's acting would have given it to them. Right. Like, how dare you?
They would have got popped on the way out.
Somebody
might have got a shank.
We might not waste our bruise on them. We might actually like throw.
No, you did. You actually did.
Leaving the game, bro. They are going to find out who they are. They're going to be ostracized to the community, bro. I swear to you, man. It's not going down like that. Unacceptable.
Boston fans aren't known for spilling drinks on people.
Steve Javy got beer pulled on him, man. We do these things. We give it to umps too. They're not safe. Referees ain't safe.
Did it to LeBron after he murdered them in game 6 last year.
Yeah, that was low class and I loved it. Absolutely low brow and I loved it.
At Wrigley Field, we could be, like, the Cubs could be getting blown out. It could be 11-0. We're still there. The Cub fans are still there to the end.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, no, that's 100 years of torture. That's a fan base.
He always has to kind of,
I mean, the Red Sox were in that state.
Diss me all
too,
the time. Damn it.
Ago.
Oh, LeBron has the headband on.
What's that? I'm sorry.
The Red Sox, I think up to like a couple months ago, had every home game sold out.
It's 7 year sellout.
Okay. So, and it wasn't that long ago that.
And again, we're not clowning Heat fans. If you're really a fan, props to you. You know what I'm saying? You got a good team to represent. I'm just saying, if you had the audacity to leave early thinking this team doesn't have a chance to come back. We play till the whistle blows, man. Everybody grew up playing
too,
at least in Pee-wee, you know, football, hockey, something.
You know
you
what
I mean? Some kind of organized sports in your life. You know it ain't over till it's over, man.
I wasn't at the game, but this is what I'm doing when they're down 5 at 28. I'm like, okay, if they hit a 3, then they're down 2.
Feel me? Yeah, they're down 13. Yeah, yeah, yeah. You're like, you'll cut it to 10 at the third. They cut it to 8, then it's to 4. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah.
You start chipping the lead.
And you start doing math in your head and you realize you're not that good at math, but then you're still like, okay.
That's awesome.
You hit a 3, then you're down 2. Then we foul.
If he makes
both, then we're down 4, and we're probably really screwed if
like
he makes both.
Like, you should anonymously forfeit your tickets for next year's if your season ticket holds and you did that. You should
I like what Bosh said. Don't come back.
Please.
Yeah. Stay home.
That's why I thought it. That's why I gave it to Bosh. That's why Bosh gave it to him.
LeBron,
don't do that, bro.
When LeBron and Wade say, I understand what it is to be a fan. You know,
no, they apologize for making it.
Yeah, I was like, what the hell?
Emotional roller coaster.
No, you know what? It's fan. Fanatic.
Yeah.
You're supposed to be emotional, man.
You can't stick on Chris Bosh that he doesn't care. My man saying that,
he's an emotional dude.
No, I
feel
that.
He's an emotional dude.
I feel that. Why would you come to our arena?
Yeah.
I used to go to Marlins game before they moved to the new stadium. I went opening day 2 years, 3 years ago before the new stadium opened up. Dude, these people showed up in the fourth inning talking about, we're going to the cameo. Let's leave. Like, dude, I am going to punch you in your face if you don't sit down. Like, yo, quiet, sit. You know, take that out to the front of the stadium, yeah, man.
Between me and Kyle, baseball, we're gonna be punching all sorts of people.
A lot of people are gonna get punched.
When we went to the World Baseball Classic, man, we were rowdy.
That
man.
Was different though, because that was like national. You don't yeah. you don't play with that. There was Puerto Rican flag.
We were all the Puerto Ricans. Were all
we had the USA flag out, like USA. Oh,
yeah, USA and nothing compared to like a Puerto Rican crazy.
Nah, I felt awesome, a little.
Yeah, 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 we're
a
like, we're like, hey, hey USA. Puerto Ricans are like, we got drums, we got a full band.
Dude, they got a whole symphony hopping out of a Volvo. Like, I mean, this is serious business.
Charanga 70. Wait, no, 76.
Have the Boston fans forgiven Bill Buckner?
Absolutely. Are you kidding me?
You ever see that documentary on Billy Buckner?
Yeah, I know, and he's still angry about it. He came out and threw a first pitch a couple years ago. What's all about Billy?
That's what irks me about Boston fans. It's
how about you get your glove down and make that play, homeboy? How about that, son?
It's over 20.
I'm just saying, he wanted to be like, oh, they caught feelings, blah, blah, blah.
I remember that game.
You screwed us, man.
He was old.
You get played to make that play, and you didn't make it. So you earn, just like LeBron, you know, bring it back, segue, you earn the criticism that comes with that. Be in that position to make that play at that time. I'm not. I'm in the stands because I don't have that skill, right? So we're all fans now watching
you. Yeah,
that's so if I can make that play, I'd be
out
there doing
it. You watch that ball over again? It wasn't an easy ball to get.
No, it was bouncing all over the ground. Yeah, it was a tough play. I'm just saying.
That's a tough ball.
Man, yeah,
and he's
saying.
Old, and he couldn't even bend at his knees.
And the thing is, you would think the smartest fan.
And it was only one out, right?
The smartest fan in
sport. No, it was two.
That was it. That was the end of the inning. We go on to win
right,
game
but it
six.
But he didn't. He didn't give up the winning run. He gave up the tying run.
Tying run.
Right.
Yeah.
So I mean, nobody gives the closer. Yo, man, close it out.
But you would imagine
there's one scapegoat play that happens. He was the guy. Sorry, bro. It happens.
But you would imagine the smartest fans in sports, the Boston fans.
I like that. I like that. I preface that statement.
Sarcasm. Yeah,
with attention.
I didn't catch that. Was it sarcasm?
Exactly.
I didn't.
They wanted to kill Billy Buck, man.
Yeah, but you.
I caught a factual statement there.
Yeah, but you would think they would have some type of perspective and be like, okay, dude.
Wow,
it's a team game.
No perspective.
It's a team game.
Absolutely not.
You know what hurt me the most?
What?
Wade Boggs crying in the dugout. Crying.
Yeah, because he knew it was over in Fenway for him.
There's no crying in baseball.
He was crying,
classic,
man.
Awesome.
And then he won. Then he won a championship with the Yankees.
Don't talk to me about
they had
Wade
him on
Boggs.
The horse riding around the field.
Add him to the list. My fist's going to be sore. It's a lot of punching going on. I hate him too. I don't care if he's 70, man. You blew it, bro. That same thing with Ray Bourque, man. Traitor. You're going to go to the Avalanche and get a ring. Like, I hate you, bro.
You guys wasn't cutting it.
Well, I mean, he was about to retire.
Yeah.
No, that was a free agent.
How about Euclid? You hate Euclid?
I have no problem with you. I didn't like him to begin with in the Red Sox.
You weren't happy when Ray Bourque won a title?
I was happy for him, I guess. Whatever.
Yeah,
sure.
That's what I'm saying. It's not like he won a title with the Rangers.
I feel you.
Johnny Damon could go rot in hell, for all I care.
Wow. See, I actually don't mind Johnny Damon either.
See,
because
he went
the circuitous route. He didn't jump right to the Yankees.
Yeah,
you know
yeah.
what I'm saying? His contract was up. I mean, the Sox did him
dirty. He went straight to Chicago. No.
Yes, dog. I'm telling you. Play with the White Sox.
The
next year, the White Sox won the World Series in 05, and they beat us in the process. They swept the Sox out of the playoffs in the process. Next season. Yes, sir. Ozzie Guillen won a championship with the White Sox that season.
John Damon, but he wasn't even a starter. He was like.
No, I'm just saying. He was God. I worked at Fenway in 04. He was literally God. He would come out in his drawers and drive his drive his Porsche.
Wait, you worked at Fenway?
No, I actually worked outside on Yawkey Way at Louis Tion stand. Dude sits next to me every night signing autographs.
Nice.
But he's out there in his drawers in a Porsche. Like, people love Johnny Damon. They had t-shirts, what would Johnny Damon do?
Yeah.
So he left. It was sad, but it was like he got forced out by a contract because Larry Lucchino was cheap.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? They, for some reason, didn't re-sign him. Went to the White Sox, did his thing, then went to the Yankees. Like,
no, Damon went straight to the Yankees.
No, I promise.
I got it right here. Look.
I'm trying to tell you, bro, this is inaccurate. He went to the White Sox in 05. Dude, I'm trying to tell you. This is a fact. This actually happened. He went to the White Sox first. I'm not going to argue with you. This actually factually happened. He won a championship in
09. You might have to call him on. He's a White Sox fan. Huge.
I'm just saying, whatever the case may be, he didn't go right to the Yankees. I don't have much beef with him. Like, I had more beef almost with what's his name, Vinatieri, for going right to the Colts.
Yeah,
but he gets a pass. He's a Florida native, so Damon gets a pass.
Well, who would you?
Yeah,
that's what's up. Yeah. Tell him. He went from the Royals to the A's to the Sox. To the Yankees.
Oh, I don't have that here. I just looked.
Are you sticking me up for this?
Maybe, no, I could have.
I swear to God, he went straight. Bro. No, I could have sworn he went straight to the Yankees.
Can we call the biggest White Sox fan in the history of?
Please do.
Because I have. Can we call him on the air?
Look, the season ended in October, and he ended it with the Sox, and then in January he signs with the Yankees. There's nothing in between.
Kyle Jones. Is that Wikipedia?
No, this is Baseball Reference.
That's not the best source.
No, this is Baseball Reference.
Well, for some reason, he still doesn't bug me either way. I don't know. Johnny Damon kind of just whooped the Yankees by himself, so I kind of have, you know, love my heart from anyway.
You weren't here in the first segment, Kyle, but what's up with Aaron Hernandez?
We might be. He might be a murderer, man.
Yeah.
Shady.
Might catch a case. We might be out two tight ends in 2 months, man.
No. The sad part is Tebow might be starting for y'all.
No.
Yo,
I
have no problem with Tebow as a backup fullback. You know what I'm saying?
Because Gronkowski's out, right?
Gronkowski's in big trouble.
Aaron Hernandez, he's got another back surgery. He's a big question mark. So who's next?
My
the backup to the backup to the backup.
They have the kid from the Giants from 2 years ago, Tammy. They stole him.
Yeah, but you know Belichick is going to start him just for the hell of it.
Oh, what's his name? Definitely getting burned, Tebow. Definitely getting burned for that.
And when you say Miami,
he hired some professional company to come clean his house.
Yeah, he's just really sketchy. He destroyed his home security surveillance tape.
Yeah.
Then he handed his cell phone to his lawyer, destroyed. And then it comes out that he hired a professional cleaning company.
Crew. You saw that on top of that, saying he shot somebody in their face in front of Tootsies.
To clean his crib
on Monday.
And he busted
their eye, and now he's in the middle of a lawsuit.
Another Jeez. Florida Gator.
This guy's Gator Alley, if you're hearing
seems
this.
A little, he seems a little aggressive. Don't fall. Get a little angry, you know?
Kind of plays football for a living.
You know what I'm saying? Gets hit a lot.
It's sad, because he's damn
good. I was just thinking last week, like, damn, Hernandez is going to have a chance to stunt this year, like, stunt heavy.
Sounds like a typical rockhead. You know,
the Dolphins will have a better record than the Patriots this year.
Don't just stop it. That's like somebody saying last year the Bills were going to win the AL East. Like,
no,
stop it.
I mean that's not far fetched,
dude.
It's not far fetched.
Are we kidding now? Fan. How is this happening? This
are you
blatant.
A Bears fan?
Bears and Dolphins.
There is no other winner from the AL East than the Patriots till Tom Brady retires.
Okay,
that's the story.
So who is he going to throw through to himself?
Whatever, dude. I'm still baseball, huh?
He throwing to himself. Who's he throwing to?
Who cares?
Okay,
doesn't matter.
We'll care.
The third, fourth best coach of all time and one of the best quarterbacks in history, though, is getting done.
Yeah, who is he going to throw to?
Belichick. They'll make it work.
He's going to throw to Belichick.
Just relax. This AL East, this AFC East is wrapped up.
Belichick's going to run
the future. The next best team, when we're done, the next best team is the Dolphins, but they're two or three seasons away.
Yeah, two or three seasons away.
From dethroning us. I know it's tough to hear. This is a fact. This is a fact of life.
It's not hard to understand.
There's death, taxes, and Patriots, bro.
Deal, you're a Dolphin fan, aren't you? Defend yourself, damn it.
No, I ain't defending them.
Man, yeah, the Dolphins are out of their way on this draft to try to stop the Patriots, man.
Well, it looks like it's not going to be that hard to do now. You done lost two of your main components.
Yeah.
Which we say this every year, but the Pats are done. The Pats have been done every year since 07.
No. But the guys they lose usually are old. They don't use two young tight ends that are really prolific.
Well, Wes Welker isn't that old.
But he's gone.
Yeah, I know he's gone too.
Look,
I can't wait to play the Broncos. Wes Welker better not come through the slot on us, man. We got players like that cat Spikes from Florida. You know, Florida dudes is goonies, man. They do not care. Dude, let him come through the slot.
I know Florida dudes are goonies. They just shot somebody in the face, allegedly.
I like that. Allegedly,
we don't want to get sued here, so we don't want George to get sued.
That's not even the case we're talking about right now. Or the case he's under investigation.
Well, he did shoot one guy in the face, apparently.
Man,
see, that's bogus. Though, he's gonna come up with a lawsuit now. Now, dude's getting
the lawsuit. They dropped the lawsuit.
They dropped it. Now they're bringing it back. Convenient. Like, now that he's suing out. Now I'm more credible.
Yeah, you are more credible. Hey, man, look.
They left with four people. They came back with three. That's pretty much.
That's like his girl sister had problems. Like, take Hannah's for me. Like, okay. Okay.
That ain't okay.
All right.
The Dolphins will have more than 10 wins this year.
I agree.
Wait a minute. He talks about a hit, and you're like, the Dolphins have 10
wins. I like that. That's why he's the host.
I'm trying to change the subject here, guys. The Dolphins will have 10 wins today. I say
under by one. I say they get nine.
If they get 9-7, that's a good year.
What was it?
Awesome.
7-9.
They were 7-9?
Yeah.
They're obviously going to be better than that because they have a much better team.
Are they, obviously?
Really? Why? They're also playing a tougher schedule.
Comes around every three, four years, they get a rough schedule.
Let's bring up the schedule.
Ugh.
We might have to go game by game.
Don't they have the toughest schedule? In the AFC East, they have the toughest schedule, man.
Well, everybody in the AFC East has about the
We'll get to it later, Deal. Are we good?
No, we're good. We have time.
Okay. I want to get to the frostbites. I'm anxious to hear what the story is. That
I saw something. I'm like, I got something for him when he thought about it.
Oh, okay.
You already know.
All right.
All right, here you go.
Quick rundown. We don't have to break down every game.
This is the Finn schedule.
Cleveland.
Win.
I just said, let's not do that.
please don't do that.
Real quick. I'll give you the win or loss. Real quick. Go.
Oh, my goodness.
And tell me if it's away or at home.
At Cleveland.
Win.
At Indy.
Lost.
Again, home against Atlanta.
You lose.
Lost.
At New Orleans on Monday Night Football.
You lose.
1-3.
So
Home against Baltimore.
That's a win.
You'll lose.
That's a win.
Home against Buffalo tracking. After a bye.
That's a win.
You're not even going to get me on this segment.
They're 3-3.
At New England.
Lost. 3-4.
By 40 points, dude.
Home against Cincinnati on Thursday Night Football.
That's a win. 4-4.
No, that's a loss. Coming off
Monday
loss
night at Tampa Bay.
That's a win. 5-4.
They got Revis now. Don't forget.
Well, who cares? He's
won. Home against San Diego. What? Yeah, home against San Diego.
That's a win. 6-4.
Home against Carolina.
That's another win. 7-4.
7-4.
You're going crazy. At New York.
It's 8-4. Let's go, the man. Jets. New York don't want it with
8-4. That's a
New York
win.
Don't want
that's
it.
It's a win.
At the Steelers.
Lost.
8-5.
Home against New England.
Lost.
They split. They split New England. 8-6,
dude.
They split.
You're crazy.
They split
just
every
stop
year.
It.
Come on, man.
No, they don't. That was what? No, they do kind of. They do.
Yeah. That's 9-6,
I'm not doing that. That's
a split. That's 9-6.
Okay.
Oh, no, you're not 9-6. You're at 9-5.
9-5. Go ahead.
At Buffalo in December.
That's a win. 10-5.
That's it right there. And then the Jets, the L's. 10-6.
Jets at home.
That's an L.
They don't lose to the Jets at home.
They split with the Jets every year.
11-5, Bubs. 11-5.
Oh, you're crazy.
Right, right here. Sports
it's also going to be true, right?
You want to know. You want to know.
20.
But by the way, you want to know what everybody else is doing when they see the Dolphins on the sketch? Win.
Yeah. Other sports shows are going, win. That's a win. Dolphins don't win.
I know it's basketball time. We're in full-blown basketball. But at some point, we had the show going on. I want to know what y'all thought about the dude the Dolphins drafted. It's not important right now. They're not the third pick.
Oh, Deion Jordan?
They went way up to get him, bro.
He's a beast, man.
He may be good.
If he's all
I'm
right.
I'm saying on a plane of like almost ignorance from college football, because I don't really study like that to know if he was
he's
really
a beast
about
in college
that
football.
Life.
He's an athletic animal, but it just depends on what defense they play.
He's like a Jason Taylor type of guy.
Yeah. Kind of. Well,
I'd hope
he'd
be a compliment, bro. Right. You'd like him to be like that, but I think he's going to be a beast because he could play both linebacker and defensive.
He's very good at pass coverage.
It's like I'd hate to reference this.
And he's what, 4'3"? So he lines up.
Yeah, but he's dude 6'6".
Yeah,
like 250.
Warren Barnes like a 4'5".
No,
like
I didn't
want to
make
type.
This comparison because we got these two.
Boston fans.
Yeah, but he's kind of like a Vrabel. I mean, he's the reason why I say what I say about the Dolphins.
I like
is because
that. Mike Vrabel's a beast.
Yeah, I mean, the reason why I say that about the Dolphins is because of the way that they're constructing the team. Yeah, they're doing it to beat. The Patriots, but the same things that the Patriots used to put themselves in
copycat
that position.
Copycat league, for sure.
You're right. Ahead of
his versatile players.
His
versatile
players.
Right.
Yeah.
So you're
right. Copycat league.
That's,
you're right.
That's what we're doing. You guys have had the opportunity to stay on top, but this is the year that it's hurting.
Can I also admit that I have egg in my face? Can I also openly admit that I completely blanked that out? I could have sworn Johnny Damon went to Chicago first. That is incorrect.
Ha! He
went right to the Yankees. And
you
I
just
still,
looked
and
at
I,
his facts.
Do you see
and
why
still,
he could rot
I still
in
feel,
him?
No, I that was saying.
You're right.
Still,
that was right.
He did us so right that I actually still feel the same way I felt before I figured that out just 2 seconds ago.
He after
he
no
went to Tampa
Johnny
Bay
Damon,
after,
but,
right?
Yeah, but after he put that whole thing painting in his house and he was on MTV Cribs and it's him as Jesus and the Last Supper, and he's like, the Yankees gonna rot in hell. I would never go to and then there you go.
It doesn't matter. My man hit a walk off, a grand slam in
Game
7.
Wait, you said on this show, oh, there's tape of it somewhere. Any dude that goes from Boston to a New York team, is dead to me.
I don't. It's whatever. I'm talking about him. We brought out. I'm just saying. I don't have animosity like I should for the fact that he helped us do the Yankees dirty. Period.
By the way, Batty.
Period.
Lighting it up.
Yep. You can hear the people downstairs yelling.
All right, the Heat are winning 18-15.
Say it again. Say it with that enthusiasm you were saying
first
earlier.
Quarter,
relax,
30
seconds.
Just 30
seconds left.
Yeah, I know. Just the same way I was saying, exactly. Relax, it's the first quarter when he was like, San Antonio's up.
Yeah.
There's Ray Allen. Ray is going to have like, what did I say Ray Allen's going to have? 22?
22.
So you want to know something about that? You know something about that? But that irks me way worse than Johnny Damon jumping ship is the fact we lost to the Heat last year. We already conquered the Yankees. Do whatever you want. We already crushed the Yankees in submission. I'm saying it was the most embarrassing 4-game set swing ever in baseball history. You know what I'm saying? We own the Yankees, bro. Do whatever you want.
Right.
The way to lose to the Heat, like, oh, they're not better than us. If you can't beat them, join them, that's lame, bro. That's why Benedict Arnold's a traitor to me. That's why I have met way more beef with Ray Allen than Johnny Damon. Way more beef because we lost to them, bro.
It's a different time. It would have been different if he would have went to the West, but to go against now it's a rival team.
Go to the Lakers, bro. Go to the Lakers. Anybody's better than the Heat, though. Now we have beef with the Heat. Honestly, I'll admit that now. Now that we're done. You know, I don't mean my boss companion up. I get so charged up. We lost. Now we have beef. We lost 2 playoffs in a row, right? That becomes a rivalry. We got beef. We got beef.
Yeah. Well.
Hey, T-Mac just touched the ball.
No.
On the bench, though.
On the bench. Okay. Oh, Deadeye.
Hey, he finally got past the first round, man.
Yeah. Too bad it's not going to help him any.
All right, when we come back, definitely Frostbites when we come back. And then we'll get into some, off topics. I gotta have some.
John, before we move on.
Yeah, go ahead. Riz.
Yo.
I did it again.
Yeah.
Sorry, man.
Sorry. What you know about this? Is it you? You caught for this?
It's Large Pro.
The heist. You're not allowed to mess with audio files anymore.
That's the way the Adobe was set up when I got to the studio, man. I'm one of those guys. If that's the way it's set up, I'm going to go with it.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Sports says on SoFloria.com.
Have you ever wondered how you could make a difference in someone's life? What if you could help hundreds or even thousands of children? You might think it impossible, but it's within your reach. Right now, today, students in the U.S. rank 32nd in world math skills. It's time for our children to catch up, and you can help. Become an owner of one of the world's fastest growing franchises, Mathnasium. Mathnasium is the leading math-only learning center in the U.S. Its only purpose is to make our kids better at math. Imagine helping hundreds, even thousands of students in your community improve in school and raise their self-esteem, all while doing something you truly love. Call us at 800-434-1360 to learn more about Mathnasium's exciting franchise opportunities. That's 800-434-1360 to learn how you can make a difference. Doing something you truly love. That's 800-434-1360. 800-434-1360.
Put a team of professional consultants behind your home or business computer with Key Information Solutions, providing solutions to your internet and computing needs while keeping you on the cutting edge of technology. Preventative maintenance and networking support, hardware and custom build computers. Let Key Information Solutions be your personal tech staff for your home or office with affordable hourly, monthly, or annual rates to fit anyone's budget. Call Key Information Solutions now, 954-973-3374. That's 954-973-3374. Or visit keyinformation.com.
Social media marketing. You know your business needs it. Mouse Media's talented team can cover a wide array of services and will work one-on-one to help you achieve your business goals. Looking for a web marketer, a social media guru, web designer, developer, programmer, or graphic designer? Yep, they got it. Visit them at mousemedia.us.
That's mousemedia.us.
Or follow Mouse Media on Twitter and on Facebook.
Mousemedia.us.
CBC5 is the executive liaison for all your building compliance needs. Serving South Florida from the Palm Beaches to Key West, CBC5 delivers five-star service that brings...
Yeah, what's this ABC, a BDQ, whatever?
CBC5. It stands for Complete Building Compliance.
Oh, I ain't building nothing, so what can they do for me?
Well, they do more than plan, review, and permitting. They help the little guy cut through red tape.
I got duct tape holding together my carport.
Well, CBC5 can help. Let them deal with bureaucrats. They helped George Rodriguez solve a sewer lateral problem, and they saved him a ton of money and hassles.
By City Hall, who can do that?
CBC5 can do that. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have a commercial to finish. Contact Shoddy the Hottie at CBC5 786-255-3851 or log on to cbc5.net. That's cbc5.net.
We asked this gentleman to participate in our radio taste test challenge. On one table, terrestrial radio. On the other, SoFloRadio.com.
Do you have your blindfold on?
Yes.
Try a bite of this.
Oh, God, that's awful. Tastes like the soiled briefs of a lonely fat man.
You just had a taste of all sports and corporate-backed right-wing assassin talk radio. Now give this a try. Mmm. That's gotta be SoFloRadio.com. Mmm. Entertaining, funny, informative. I love it. Can I have more?
SoFloRadio.com. A full plate of delicious entertainment.
Join the club that gives you stuff.
Hey, thanks!
Radio Loyalty.
Here's how it works.
Just click on the Radio Loyalty banner right now and sign up. Then, you keep on listening like you already do. But now you earn points. Those points add up, and you can trade them in for stuff in the Radio Loyalty store. Earn more points by sharing your station with friends on Facebook and Twitter, answering surveys, and by using the apps in the New Players App Store. Pretty simple, right? Radio Loyalty. Click that banner to join now.
Scales.
All right, Frostbites segment here.
Yes, sir.
I say why you had it. Shouts RIP to Guru, man.
RIP to the Guru. One of the best of all times. All right, Jack Frost, the floor is all yours.
Yeah, I appreciate that, Johnny. I just wanted to talk about a couple things. Usually on Frostbites, I like to hit you up with the SMH of the day, which usually are those, you know, those moments.
I'm
that
sorry, you say the SMH of the day?
Shake my head of the day. Like, you know.
That's awesome.
You know?
I'm sorry.
It's just a couple things that just have you scratching your head, like this recent article I was reading about Facebook and sending pictures. Favorable pictures of sexting. Whoa. Sometimes the recipient is not always the person that wants to see it. There's a situation here where this guy, his name will be held out for. His name is Trevor. Forget it.
You don't have to say his last name. You're good with that.
Yeah, yeah. We're good on that.
I know a Trevor. You know a Trevor. Everybody knows Trevor.
But now we all know Trevor.
Not me.
Now here's the thing with Trevor. He sent a picture. He hooked up with a chick on, I believe it was Tumblr or Facebook.
Okay.
And it started.
How do you hook up with a chick?
You're already saying all the wrong things.
Hey, man, I like your blog.
I'm looking at it here. It says the Tumblr user, but the original article that I read was Facebook. Now, they hooked up and exchanged information, and they stayed in contact with each other, whatever. And I guess Trevor felt he could take it a step further and send a picture of his man parts.
Mm.
She wasn't impressed. And you know, she
putting
gave
that mildly, I assume.
I mean, she didn't. Let's just say she's a lady with standards.
Okay.
She didn't find it impressive. Trevor pushed on a little harder than he was supposed to. Guess what the young lady did? She saw
put
that
it on Facebook.
She saw well that too. She saw that Trevor's mom followed him on Facebook also.
Oh.
So she sent the pictures to his mom.
No.
Oh.
This is what your son is doing. So that is a major SMH of the day right
Damn.
There for Trevor right there. And on a sad note, man, you know, I know Father's Day just recently passed. I'm pretty sure you guys heard about what happened recently to DJ Quick's daughter.
Oh, yeah, I heard about that.
Yeah.
Did not.
His daughter and boyfriend.
Talking about DJ Quick, Snoop, all them?
Yeah, yeah.
Really?
West Coast legend. West Coast legend DJ Quick's daughter. The child was they were arrested for killing DJ Quick's 2-year-old grandson.
What?
Who?
You're saying
happened?
His daughter got arrested for killing her daughter?
Well, the daughter,
that's what you're saying,
the
right?
Father, the father of the daughter,
the father of DJ Quick's daughter's.
I'm thrown off right now.
I got this. DJ Quick's son-in-law killed his kid.
Well, technically, not married.
Killed
but,
DJ
yeah.
Quick's granddaughter.
Right, right. But yeah. I mean, it's easier to put it that way.
Yeah, yeah.
Really?
But, yeah. She got arrested because what happened was they both got into an argument, allegedly, and the child soiled the bed, and he went off.
Damn.
You know,
what, like beat her or shook her or something?
Well, beat the child. You know, they just had an argument, those
for
two. So she stayed.
The bed.
Yeah. So she wanted to stay out of it and didn't want to, you know, intervene. That is an accessory to murder. So,
I hate stories like that, man.
You know, our prayers go out to the family. Hope things that work out for them.
Damn, man, really? That's terrible, bro.
Yeah, yeah. I didn't want to.
There's nothing more soft and just disgusting in the world than murdering kids or like abusing kids, man.
Yeah,
you gotta be kidding me, bro. Even with women, because they might know Taekwondo.
Right.
They might knock you out. They might have mace on them. You know what I'm saying? That's disgusting.
That might be Ronda Rousey on the street.
You know, as a father myself, I just felt like I felt compelled to talk about it because I feel the same way. You know, no matter who it is, whether it's the father of the child or, you know, somebody that, you know, you're kicking with a boyfriend,
that's way
or girlfriend,
worse, man, with your,
you don't
parent?
Yeah, it's own,
terrible,
it's own
bro.
Kid, and that's real sad. But
what type of person are you, man?
On another note, we've got. This is a topic I want to talk about because I'm kind of sick of it when it comes to hip-hop clothing lines. Everybody named Mother's coming out with clothing lines now. The latest to do so is rapper
I'm still rocking
Prodigy.
FUBU.
Prodigy.
Oh
Prodigy. You kind of passed
by the way,
man.
You don't tell
feel
people
me?
That.
FUBU
is
the best.
You kind of passed your prime to put out gear, right? I mean,
yeah.
you ain't been relevant since 2004, right? Let's be serious.
I'm still rocking FUBU.
Probably,
FUBU.
Yeah.
Don't tell people
right?
That.
I mean, let's be real with us. Time out. You know what I'm saying?
The rapper Prodigy is coming out with a collection called Infamous.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is on the heels of his project, his new LP that he's dropping with Alchemist called Albert Einstein.
I can't go wrong with Al. The whole
Alchemist.
Up.
Yeah. Can't go wrong with Alchemist.
How are you talking?
So he kind of gets a plus and a
put
minus.
Put out the gear for that, though.
You know, leave the gear alone and put out more material.
Yeah. Stick to the music.
Hey, I can't lie. All the gear out, if it was hard-bodied enough, I would absolutely rock Infamous gear. I can't even lie. That's a big, huge part of who I am as a man growing up in my childhood, man.
Oh, man. I can't do it.
Mobb Deep is coming down to Miami in August, by the way.
Where?
Hey-o.
Both of them?
Where?
Yeah. The stage.
Well, and,
do you know what I'm saying? What's his name? Got that sparkly billionaire boys club, the X with the fruity stars on it. Pharrell can do that. Prodigy can drop Infamous. Let's be serious.
Yeah, but Pharrell did it while he was hot.
That's what
so
Raekwon played
like,
there.
Yep.
Couple
True.
Yeah.
Same spot. Came
out too late.
I also
I didn't go because
I also found a little tidbit of information. Well, a little fun that I found. Brian Williams. I didn't know he was a Snoop Dogg fan like that.
Which Brian Williams are you talking about? The newscaster?
The newscaster.
Really?
NBC 6 newscaster. Dropping a little old school knowledge.
Mm-hmm.
Let me see if we can peep it right here.
Oh, but that's what Jimmy Fallon
NBC
does.
News anchor Brian Williams gotta hear this. Edited to make it look like he's performing the Snoop Dogg classic Ain't Nothing But a G Thing.
You gotta see the Ice Cube. It was a good day.
They got that one too?
Yep.
1, 2, 3, after the fourth, Snoop Doggy Dogg and Dr. Dre is at the door. Ain't nothing but a G thing, baby. Two poked out G's, so we're praised. C, Death Row is the label that pays me, so just a shield. To the next episode.
Nice.
Look up the Ice Cube. It was a good day. Look up the Ice Cube. It was a good day. I but promise you, it is the most funniest thing. Seeing him say AK is the most funniest thing I've ever seen.
But on another note, I'm pretty sure everybody while watching, I believe it was Game 6 or Game 5, one of the two, during halftime, they were premiering Jay-Z dropping the news about his 12th studio album called Magna Carta, The Holy Grail. That's dropping soon, but this is the thing about Jay-Z and what he's doing. He's being innovative because, as the commercial tells you, you know, he's calling the internet the Wild West right now. Everybody's, you know, finding plenty of ways to like pirate your music and all that other stuff. So this is what Samsung is offering. You know, they're offering a free copy of the album for the first 1,000,000 people that buy a Samsung Galaxy S3, and I'm not going to give any more promo to Samsung because I don't got one.
I got one.
But for the most part, for the first 1,000,000 people that get the album, he'll end up being platinum before the album even drops.
Can we admit that Jay-Z's the most gangster rapper of all time?
He is the smartest businessman.
The smartest, most savviest.
Okay,
most
smart. I give you the smartest businessman.
I'm saying gangster
Give
like,
it to you.
In a professional, real, right. Swaggy, G'd up way.
He's a
like,
hustler.
He's a
genius.
He is the most iconic rap symbol ever in history.
He's not a businessman.
Jay-Z do it like nobody else,
he's
bro.
Not
come
the,
on,
he's
man.
Not a businessman. He's a
businessman.
But the questions, my top five that I got for you about Jay-Z right now, I'm going to try to run through them for you. The questions that we might have about this album. Jay has never slacked when it comes to his tracks. I didn't mean to do that. With appearances by Timbaland, Pharrell, Swizzy, and the legendary Rick Rubin, it doesn't look like he's going to change now. But usually, you know, Hov usually gives you a new up-and-coming producer, Hit Boy.
He stays with Hit Everything.
Ball So Hard.
Kanye, he introduced the world of Kanye.
Kanye, Just Blaze, Ninth Wonder.
God. He had Drake fresh out of his just incarnation, man. Ooh. He had Drake when Drake wasn't, you know what I'm saying, still coming up.
Yeah, but producer-wise, who's going to be the new board bomber to get the nod this time around?
Well, do you have the answer, or are you?
No, that's just a random question. Let's see where it goes. In regards to the Samsung deal.
He put Ninth Wonder on.
Hey, he did. Lil Brother. Big fan of Lil Brother.
Oh, I love Lil Brother.
See, actually, I can't stand Lil Brother's rhymes, but Ninth Wonder's the ish, man.
I love Lil Brother.
But with the RIA certifying as such, in regards to the first 1,000,000 people that get the Samsung products, will there ever be a larger deal than that? You know, because that's a real smooth move that Jay-Z pulled
off.
The
first 1,000,000 people that get the Samsung. Get the free
the app, right?
Free, yeah,
it's an
because
app.
Samsung already bought 1,000,000 albums.
Right.
So the first person to get that.
Wow.
The app, or it's an app, I think, right? Or is it
no.
the phone?
The actual
phone.
Galaxy actual, phone, with the 5 or the 6.
Wow. It's the 4. It's the 4. The 3 and the 4, and the Galaxy Note.
Wow.
See, you guys still got me to say that.
Well, I have one, though. What happens
to
me?
Why.
I got one, too.
Well, you blew it, but it's like getting an SI subscription before they win the championship. You don't get all that cool stuff in it. You're X'd out, bro. It's too late.
You're X'd out. No grandfather.
Yeah, no, I don't get mad at it.
Waiting for the Samsung, kid.
I don't get mad at it.
Yeah, no Madden subscription, no game, no free controller, no none of that.
Well, the third question here, during the clip, Jay can be seen explaining Rick Rubin about the album and the duality of it. How it's trying to navigate your way through the whole thing, through the success, through the failures, and all that. The question poses, the original Magna Carta was written to limit the power of kings. Can the king of the triple entendre rewrite the rules while still being so entrenched in the status quo? Mm-hmm. So it's a nice little question. It's asking him, like, you know, him being the top dog or whatever, will he be able to make these type of judgments while still, you know, in the thick of it? So that's that question. The number four question is, what the heck is this app about that they're releasing on the album for Samsung?
Doesn't matter.
Something
it's
awesome,
out of
I'm sure.
Yeah, yeah.
Something groundbreaking and pioneering and completely badass.
And the final question.
How much money is Jay-Z making out of all this?
He'd be the first billionaire rapper.
Yes. I thought he already is.
He'll touch that. No, he ain't doing that.
He's getting there. He's not there.
Probably 750 mil strong, something like that.
Damn.
The final question is, and I saw this a few weeks ago, Jay-Z Instagrammed this photo. Well, a photo.
Talk about them three.
Of Nas. Yeezus!
I seen that.
In the studio. Yeah. So are the Godson and Yeezus Christ slated to be on the album? So that's the last out of the five.
I hope, because it'll make the album better.
Yeah, and it won't be because of Jay-Z.
No, that'll be the holy grail for real.
I would really God like it son, if he just shut his mouth Jesus. And it just made beats, man.
Exactly.
J-Hope.
I don't think he's a great beats. Lyricist, to be
Talk
honest
about, he has a track on his CD called I Am a God.
Did
you know that?
Album.
Yeezus? It's hot?
Mm-hmm.
Who has that album?
You're not going to like it.
Jay-Z?
Why not?
Because
it's different.
It's completely
what does that mean
different?
What are you saying? I don't accept difference.
Do you listen to Daft Punk?
That first track
to
who?
You listen to Daft Punk?
No, you don't.
Daft Punk? I was in that track with Pharrell on it.
That's not the same type of
thing. No, this
what
is
does
like,
that mean?
This is old school. He incorporated like electronic music with his rhymes.
Yeah, all right, that awesome, first, no doubt.
Wait, hold up. Hold up. Let me just get the first track.
See,
that first
said
track
that, though.
You
saying like I'm not hip. Like I
no,
want
I'm
cheap.
No,
I'm trendy. I'm saying I'm not.
I'm not saying
I'm
trendy.
Out of sight. We know you're trendy. I mean, you came over on the Kendrick Lamar vibe, so you definitely got points for that.
Is that like the Woo with the Beatles or Jimi Hendrix beats in the background?
I doubt it. It's a whole different thing, bro.
Very different.
That's whack, man.
Click the Yeezy full album because it's the first. No, right there, the fourth one. Yeah.
I mean, this is the same dude that brought us 808s and Heartbreaks and all this other various nonsense.
Oh no,
man.
that was bad.
So y'all heard it? I'm saying I feel obviously.
I only heard the first.
The Yeezus.
You showed me the first track.
She was playing. Dude. She was playing a couple clips for us.
This is the first track on the album.
What's this?
There's On Sight.
Kanye West's new album that dropped Tuesday.
This is one half of Daft Punk producing.
I feel like I'm in mansion.
That's awful. That's hip hop.
That's not hip hop.
No, it's not.
That's the beauty of it. It's not just hip hop.
It's about the emotion.
You see that, man? It must be nice, bro, to be 19, 20 years old, man. It's completely lost me, dog. This is an approaching. Fuck whatever y'all been.
All right, that's just a beat. I'm not going to get into it because then it's going it's gonna go into bomb after bomb after bomb.
It's going to get real explicit.
Real soon.
Nah. Big Daddy Kane, KRS-One, Chuck D.
God, leave it alone.
Biggie.
I just said the
those guys
don't
are like,
don't put them in the same category. Don't do that. Don't put Biggie in the category
on.
With them, bro. Stop that.
That beat was cool.
Raekwon.
You know what you sounded like. You know what you sounded like, right?
What?
At my age, we took the bus both ways home. We walked up
you
to
like
the
that? House. Kyle, you like that?
No, I just told
not,
you
it's
I
not a
like
matter
it.
Of like oh, it doesn't matter who we put in front of you. You're still going to point at it and be like, ah, it sucks. That's not Raekwon.
That's I don't not me.
That's
not. You're not talking about me.
We're talking,
about him.
No, we're talking about him,
the host.
Definitely. We're talking about
talking
the
about ancient, ancient.
I'm
you know what I'm saying?
I'm like that about rap, too. I'm with you,
dude.
John. I don't like too
I'm
many
just a
of
fan
the
of
hip hop,
man. All this new crazy
no, no, no,
stuff.
No. You're a fan of a specific type of hip hop.
Yeah.
A specific
yo, in their
era.
Defense, though, we got to accept it. We get left behind, for real.
Yeah.
I'd rather be left behind.
I would not.
See?
I'd rather have my tapes and my CDs.
I'd rather.
I'm
geared
up for the future.
My old 90s hip hop and leave it alone.
I go mid-80s.
You're in an era where we're early privileged 80s. Enough to be old enough where you have the backing of the older generations and you can experience the new generations. I feel blessed.
Yeah.
I came from, look, the first computer I ever saw was
like
1989. It was a black computer with green writing.
Yeah.
Look, look who it came since.
I
then.
Used that in
it's
kindergarten.
Hangman, the and it came down a line. Now we're here. I mean, you got you, Jay. I'm filming in their defense. You got to appreciate.
Did you play
that.
Wheel of Fortune on the computer?
You know I played Wheel of Fortune. Yeah. Hangman, you know what I'm saying?
Frost got one more story. Go ahead, Frost.
Well, one more is dealing with. I wouldn't say this is hip hop related, but.
Do I need the clip?
No. This is good. This is different. This is a little bit off subject.
Give it to us, baby.
Corinne Steffens.
Who's that, Superhead?
A.K.A. Superhead.
Wow. How do you know that?
Hey-o!
Why is he so relevant?
Mr. Marcus.
Yes, exactly. The title Gucci. The title is...
Superhead. The porn star that put all them dudes under the bus. She screwed Ye and Shaq.
She was a video vixen. And she,
oh, God.
She put out a book saying who she banged. Talking about DMX cried when he had sex.
Yeah, she worked her way up.
Like that. Said he whimpered when he had sex.
She worked her way up.
He didn't bark like a dog.
Through hip-hop.
She was like Kim Kardashian before Kim Kardashian.
but she gave it up
so she didn't
way
get
more.
Pregnant. And she didn't put it on too many tapes.
Right.
How does a woman... I'm saying this respectfully because of Steph here. How does a woman just say...
She wanted the fellas now, man. That's tough. She
but how does a woman just say, "I just want to be, I want to be a porn star"?
I want to have sex and get paid for it.
I can't get that in my mind. Well, before, a woman saying,
if you're already a whore and you look good, then why would not make money off of that?
Get paid for it.
Well, before we even go there,
but I'm saying, like, isn't that?
Yeah, I like to hear what you. I like. Yeah, we can debate that all day.
Let me clarify that. You know, she was a video chick.
Yeah,
I think she did deal with a porn star.
Mr. Marcus.
Who happened to have syphilis now and passing it around like
this. He has a HIV or whatever?
What's your thing, though, with her? We all know she's a whore. I mean,
she has a HIV?
Well, with her is...
Tell me something I don't know. Tell me something breaking news.
Thing you don't know about her is that she's coming out with a comic book.
What?
Awesome.
Yeah. Confessions of a video. What,
Confessions of a Hooker?
And she's also dropping...
Is it an adult comic book?
She's dropping
an album.
Yeah, it's an adult comic book, but she's dropping... So it's hentai. She's dropping another book... called Confessions of a Video Vixen 10 years later. Wow, that's interesting.
Nobody cares, Mara. She's a whore. For real. You should have gobbled that up when you had a chance, man. Like,
literally. She already did. That's why she's doing it. She's been gobbling up for the past 10 years. Yeah. She needs to talk about it some more.
Yo, remember this, dog, when she came out with Shaq and Kobe's like, man, I should have my woman get paid to not talk like Shaq does?
Yeah. Well, this is the comment that Corinne came out with. She said, in the coming week, I will unveil the title and promotional art of my very first graphic novel.
Wow, guess what, lady? It's going to be a graphic
novel.
Especially for my Comic-Con enthusiasts.
Really?
Simultaneously.
Nobody at Comic-Con knows who Corinne Stevens is.
No, I guarantee if she put out a hardcore comic book, she'll cop it.
But nobody knows who it is.
They said star who? Uh-huh. Track what? Corinne Stevens.
Simultaneously, she said, I'm also working on Confessions, like I said, of Video Vixen 10 years later for the summer of 2015. I can't wait to see that.
Don't you learn little kids not to chew and screw? Mm. Remember that? Not supposed to do that, man.
She must have missed that.
But she ain't chewing. She's sucking. So what's that word?
Whoa. Sucking duck.
There you go.
Frostbite. Good job, man. Boom.
Hey.
All right.
Yeah, I like that.
Let's go here.
Cold blooded.
30. What's the score? 30-27. How many minutes left? I can't see.
6 minutes to go in the sucking. This is a low scoring game, dude.
So everybody here predicted. Everybody
just the way the Spurs. Like it.
Everybody here predicted it's going to be a close game, and that's what it is.
You know that, right? That grind down game, that possession for possession. You know, the Spurs live for that, bro.
We could do that.
I know that he can, too. That's why y'all champs.
You guys hear about the Iverson story?
33-27.
Allen Iverson?
What happened?
What, he's broke?
No.
What
else? Again?
His wife, because, you know,
he's kidnapping.
Exactly.
Dude, I saw that.
Oh, my God.
You picked the wrong chick to deal with, bro. Unless you're just crazy.
I think the court dropped it.
We talking about kidnapping, man. not practice. We talking about kidnapping. Not child support. We talking about not armed robbery. We talking about kidnapping.
You guys hear the story about 2 Chainz when he got robbed and all his bodyguards like took off?
And then he got arrested. he got robbed in San Fran. Got arrested in L.A. on a gun possession.
All his bodyguards left him.
Ouch,
left
bro.
Him by himself.
Not a good weekend.
I left that out of Frostbite because there was some conflicting words.
All right, that's it. That's the end of the show.
Oh,
Dio's giving us the 10 seconds. All right, thanks for logging on, tuning in. This was the Sports Head Show on SoFloRadio.com.
Game 7, baby.
Game 7. Follow John Nash on Twitter.
Do or die.
SoFloRadio.com and SoFloTelevision.com.
It's all the way in the back.
Okay, all
to your right.
I'll point it to you. No, it's on this
It's on this floor.
You need the key, though. Is the key on the door? Where's the... Do you have the prison key? The hooks. Oh, no. Oh, okay. Every Monday with Connecticut School Broadcasting, East 7th Avenue, 36th Street, right there. It's real close to your school. Can we get it early? Why did you get it early?
Talk right game, game seven, hockey, baseball, frostbites.
Yeah, and hip hop. A whole lot of hip hop. That's the cool thing. I would do a little more, keep more with the hip hop, especially with this
particular crowd. Yeah.
Because you got Kyle, you have Jack.
We did half out today.
Yeah, we did. Yeah. But you know, I mean, just the way you kind of incorporate it, I would keep doing that.
It's like a nice little build up.
Yeah.
Because once I come in.
Because then once you drop them every once in a while, because like you'll drop it throughout the show. And it's kind of funny, especially mm-hmm. with the tracks that are playing.
Yeah.
Hit that shit, you piece of motherfucker. God damn. Sit him down. He hasn't hit anything.
Who's that?
Chalmers. He's playing really bad.
But no, if we bleed it in there, like, you know, make our little references here and there, it's a nice little setup, so.
Yeah, and it's different.
Yeah. Instead of it just being like frostbites and I just come right in. You know what I'm saying?
Also do whatever.
Like a build-up. Like as we going along, you know, like a tease. Okay, frostbites is coming up. Like we just talked about. Like we talked about the 2 Chainz shit. Like, okay, there's going to be more of that coming up on the frostbite segment. Whatever.
Yeah, because, I mean, that's what makes your show different. You can do like hip-hop and sports.
Yeah.
And I'm going to tell you the truth, the two of them kind of go together.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's what people like nowadays.
Yeah. Sports
and nobody wants strictly sports anymore. It doesn't exist.
So what are you saying? Say again. Frostbite,
well, like a setup, you know, like a you're always teasing it.
Yeah,
and when you tease the way you tease it, you tease it with certain topics. You know what I'm saying? Like, okay, 2 Chainz. I heard what's going on with 2 Chainz. Like you don't have it within your
halftime, man. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I did. I mean, you have a dialogue.
That's why I don't want
you're going to hear the rest of that and more.
I got hash oil.
You know, Kyle's going to jump in. Yeah. Steph's here. She's going to jump in. So it's not like it's just me and you. We all jump in.
Right? We smoke off. Fuck it. We're going to do it. This dude came with this stuff. It's like a condensed, thick.
Is that black?
Like, it's like solid.
Black?
No, it's brown. Dark brown.
Yeah, it's hash.
It's like hash. But it's like you got to cook it. It's like cooking a crack. You got to heat it up.
Butter.
And then
butter,
it goes,
right?
It turns into like drippy. And you like lace your blunt with
butter,
it.
Butter.
What, son? How you would get steamy?
I don't know. Once you need me to use a torch, boom. Once you need me to use a torch, I feel like I'm doing crack.
Stop it. We kind of just scraping it now and putting it in. Cause I
yeah, I'm like, yo, and what are we doing?
Can't cook, man.
What happened to this just being weed?
Hey,
speaking of, you got your magic pen?
I ain't bringing it, but he's got one.
Where we gonna go? Special K, you got a Twitter?
Huh?
You got a Twitter?
Yes, sir. What the hell is my Twitter? I don't even know. I post my Instagram. I post all that shit.
What do you go by on Facebook?
see, my bad. I didn't have to shit down.
No, I thought it was.
You gonna go across the street to the pub?
What are you gonna do?
I'm going home, dude. I gotta work tomorrow. And I'm going out tomorrow. And Saturday. And
hey, you want dip now? So you be home by the end of halftime or something?
That was my plan, but.
Get it then.
You're tempting me to go somewhere and watch the game.
What I'm saying, I don't want to miss enough. We're gonna go. We should go now because it's not even halftime yet, man. I want to be home by the beginning of third quarter, bro. Let's be, almost been chilling, man.
The thing is that I don't want to go to a place to watch the game.
Misses. Rebound, Bosch.
So I know when it could.
That was the.
They were
just heartbroken, right?
That doesn't mean anything.